What's up, Velocity? How you guys doing? It's Wednesday. We are here. We're so glad you're here as well. We're so glad you decided to tune in and worship with us tonight. And man, we got some cool stuff planned for you tonight. We're in the middle of our series called The Chase. We're in week 2 tonight. And we hope you guys were able to tune in last week. But we got some surprises planned for you, as always, once again here at Velocity. But in order to get things rolling, of course, we got a game for you. We want to play with you. So let's hit that Game Guy music. Let's get those people up here. Let's go.
How's it going?
What's up?
Yeah. Hey, everybody.
All right.
Katie almost killing me every time you walk back.
Yeah,
on
I
stage.
Did. Sorry.
Yeah, up here with my two favorite Petes. Oh, that's not true, Nikki and Megan.
Yes,
no.
You hear that.
That's not true.
Two of my favorite Petes. That's what I meant to say. That's what I meant to say.
That's it.
We all know what I mean.
Yeah. We're the favorites. So, Katie, why don't you let us know what we're doing tonight?
We are playing a game, part 2 for us, of a game we played a few weeks ago called YouTube Showdown.
YouTube Showdown. Let's go.
So if you guys don't remember, we're going to show you 2 YouTube videos, and then you vote which one got more views.
That's right. Yep. And as always,
Kahoot.
Dot there's it. A Kahoot.
I
dot it. Kahoot.
We're not
it.
Playing that game this week, Jared.
Yeah, no more fart jokes. We're all done with Cannon Fart. That's
we
a thing of the past.
It's never too
done.
Much.
I really hope there's a fart video in this so I can bring
okay,
it back.
Okay, that would kind of be hilarious.
Okay.
Yeah, so how do they vote for in the Kahoot for this one? Is it blue is the first video, red's the second?
Red is second, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so if you one think it's the two. First video, you vote blue.
Just look in the chat, we'll tell you.
Yeah,
for
we'll
sure.
tell you in the chat too. Yeah. And the code will be in the chat as well.
Yes.
For you
yes.
to get into Kahoot yes, so you can play a game with us. And as always, our prize is we'll bring you lunch
Yum.
On Thursday.
Uh-huh. Door.
Last week,
Dash.
It was Ezra won some Chick-fil-A. And man, listen, so I delivered the Chick-fil-A because you said DoorDash was expensive. The line for Chick-fil-A wrapped
it's
around
absurd.
The building.
Did you go to
so,
Talmadge?
Huh?
The one off Talmadge.
The Talmadge one. Yeah.
That's yep. Talmadge
is crazy. C-Core.
Dude, it
I
was
C-Core
or Central.
It was bananas. But we love you guys. And they get people through. At Chick-fil-A, they get people through, you know?
That's true.
They be
good.
They got
they
their stuff together.
Jesus
it's funny because they talk so much too.
Yeah.
Like
they're so nice.
They're very
but
personable.
They move you through. I don't know. Anyway, Kahoot.it, code is in the chat.
And
we have an excuse to watch a bunch of YouTube videos.
Yeah.
So. All right. Are we ready?
I think
we're
so.
We're ready.
All right.
Yeah.
I hope you're ready.
Let's see the first one, Benny.
I like to sing, dance, pretend, and kazoo. Kazoo.
It's not so important. Should have.
Oh, surprise! I have some pretzels for you.
Do you know what you just said?
Well, you're cheery.
Me? I'm always like this.
Oh, yeah, sure.
You're certainly not going to be.
When can I see
you're
you
bad
walk
company.
Away? Can't wait.
Oh, you suck. Now's your chance.
Well, you
call
can be a funny wiener, can't you?
All right.
Oh, my gosh.
Go.
Oh.
Was the first one like a commercial?
That's what
kazoos?
I was just gonna ask.
Or was it real?
There's no way that remember. Kid was that good at that being that excited.
There's
to
a
play
lot
kazoos
of videos
yeah.
of him on YouTube.
Yeah, there's there like, is.
The same kid?
Who are
yeah.
you?
What the heck are you?
He has more videos. I don't yeah. know what they're from.
Dude, it's
but...
that classic bowl cut.
Well, he's probably like a billionaire now because he probably has a billion hits.
Well, that was it. That was quick.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Just wow. kidding.
I'm gonna say number one.
Two
it's gotta
is super
be Kazoo
funny,
Kid.
But
two
I would really
one.
Think it's Kazoo I, Kid.
Yeah.
I'm gonna think it's Kazoo Kid. Let's see it, Benny. Which one?
No.
No way.
Kazoo Kid looks like that stereotypical like clip art like child that you can
that.
Use for generic
the
video.
The Google images. Yeah. What are they? Yeah.
All right. So,
annoying kid. Kazoo Kid pops up.
So some of you, if you're better at this than
okay,
us,
well.
Some of you have a point. And once again, to vote in the game, you can check it out in the chat. But I believe it's blue is 1, red is 2.
Yes.
Pretty sure.
Yep. Yes.
All right. 0000.
Sad.
We suck.
All right.
Yes, we're all buying you DoorDash.
Awesome.
We're too excited for the kazoo.
All right. Well, I'll deliver it together. All right. Are we ready for the next one?
Separate cars. DoorDash parade.
Oh, that'd be sweet.
We each get a different.
Jared
item.
Has the fries. Katie has the drink.
That's
all right.
Funny. All right. Moving on.
Benny.
Enough silliness. Let's see the next one.
Anyway.
Clint Eastwood?
Wow, that's going to be you, Mark.
See, that's nowhere.
That will be me, totally, 100%.
That's really go. Not. The thing is, I feel like every old person in the world, when they try to floss, does that, though. So that's not that funny to me.
It's like, pretty funny.
If it's Clint Eastwood,
is it not?
Funny.
I think it
is
Clint Eastwood.
I can't see that far away. I don't have glasses.
That would have a huge impact on the number of votes too.
Yeah.
If it's Clint Eastwood, it'd be a lot more than just random old guy flossing.
Random old guy flossing on the beach.
That's why flossing on the beach.
But what if he's actually
flossing?
Dude,
I have no idea. Okay, I've never seen either of these videos, so.
I don't know.
I think I'm gonna say
animal
one.
Animal videos always get so much.
Yeah,
I think it's gonna be goat.
I don't know. I'm gonna go with two.
Goat, right. Push, and
we'll split it.
Pete's be riding together.
Two for each. Oh,
dang it.
Oh my
that's
gosh.
A lot more.
Not
Let's
even close.
Go. It's gotta
this
be hidden.
Sucks.
That's so
this
many
does suck. We're terrible at these games. Dang, man. Okay.
Dude, I've won like the past 3 weeks. I've lost. Well, the past two were about farts, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm terrible at these games. All right.
Okay.
So 1-1, 0-0. All right. Let's see you next one. In a factory.
Come on, Pickett, let's go. Keep walking. You keep walking.
Those wet floors.
She did fall.
What's going on?
Okay, well.
This is not as funny as Volume 1.
Yeah, those were that funny, but go.
Was the first one just funny because they got on? Caught on tape, hardcore dancing.
I feel like they probably didn't know, but I thought they were going to smash into something.
Yeah, I thought they were
like
going to knock over a bunch
of
boxes.
I keep waiting for the punchline in these, and it just doesn't happen.
They must have low views, right?
I mean, the first two did. Like, in the last one, they had millions of views.
Yeah.
The last one was like 20,000.
I think Volume 1 just had all the heavy hitters.
Yeah, Volume 1. Yeah. I thought Volume 5 would be fresh, you know? I don't know.
I'm going to say number 2, because she actually
no
fell
idea.
And wipeout videos. All
right, I'll go number 1. I'll be different. All right, let's see it, Benny.
It's number 1.
Dang it.
Let's go.
Oh, my gosh. 1,000 views more. No.
Let's go.
I need to stick with you. You mean 1,000,000 views more?
Okay, whatever.
I was like,
it's a 1 and a bunch of zeros.
Views Katie's more. In college, too. She's
yeah,
in college.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've done math,
it's
guys. Come here, break.
Exactly. Yeah.
All right, so everyone's got one but Jared.
Can't see.
I don't know what you guys are talking about.
He goes, it's almost exactly.
I couldn't see.
Like getting closer
I don't
makes
have
the math easier.
Oh, my gosh. We're losing control, people.
Sorry.
It's almost the end of the year.
Getting
we're just coming
quarter.
Off the rails
can
over
I
here.
Zero
all points. Right. Everyone has
okay,
one except Jared.
Too long.
Jared.
All right.
Ooh, moving on.
Fight you.
Let's see you next one.
What are you doing?
Vai pra frente, Dora!
That's like
that was
me
funny.
Bowling. You throw it backwards and they all jump and spin
that was
around.
Pretty funny.
Yeah.
All right, go.
That one you just hit it.
Oh my goodness. I've had bowling balls like stick before, but I've never thrown them that high.
At the screen, man. Oh my gosh.
Oh, Dad had one jump lanes and knock pins down in the other lane.
That's always the worst thing. You just look at the people, you're like,
sorry. So sorry.
Well, we
sorry.
Got a
so
pin
sorry.
Like stuck in the gutter, and his ball went hit the pin in the gutter and jumped over the middle. And
oh my gosh,
it was funny.
Okay.
Next week's game,
right,
I'm just gonna fight Mark.
I'm voting one.
I've seen number one.
I'm voting
I'm
one.
Go two,
yeah, that's
I
what I'm basing on too,
because
I've seen it.
I think it's funnier. All right, so I'm going
let's
it
see.
Is funnier, but I've seen number
yeah.
one.
Yeah, number oh,
that's
crushed
a
it.
Lord.
Close. All right, so I have two.
I have one.
You have two. One. 2-2-1-1.
Oh, Ellie.
Me and Katie. Boop. Quarantine high five.
This is
all
where
right.
I make my
right.
climb.
Let's see.
Is it?
Let's go.
Or fall yes. like that guy in the video.
I was thinking.
What is happening? Are those dolphins?
Gosh.
He
just
got him.
Got straight up checked.
Boom.
Oh,
no.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
And gave up and
dude, that,
no.
be, that would be me running up that hill 100%. That's a video of Mark.
What happened?
Oh, Ben just jumped it. It's
anyways,
okay. We can still vote on
that
this one.
That dude totally just accepted
yeah.
like, falling
he just like,
in.
Nope.
Yeah, he just gave up. That was a look of defeat.
He just, no.
I
he didn't even try to like catch
I haven't seen either of these, but getting checked by a dolphin is pretty.
That's pretty.
That's got to be pretty rare. That's got to be a lot of views.
Yeah. That dolphin just came up and was like.
But people falling down is like a whole subgenre of YouTube too, though.
Fail army.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go. Number two.
I'm still gonna go one.
I'm gonna say one just because dolphins.
Yeah. Say
two.
Say two.
I found a pot of dolphins.
Oh my gosh! Oh, those are low counts, bro. More people got to see that dolphin hip checking that guy.
That was funny. Share it with your friends.
So what do we have? Yeah. I have two.
I'm back to last.
Three.
Three. Two. Two.
One.
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 All right. Once again, Kahoot.it if you want to join in the game right now.
Closing the chat.
And we have the code in the chat. And blue is one. Red is two.
Yes.
Two. Vote. Are we ready for another
one? In the chat.
I'm ready.
Yeah.
All right. Let's hit it.
Is Jared ready to keep losing?
Shut up.
That's really funny.
I want that one. If I saw a hamster doing that, I would buy it.
Dude, just that was my dog in her last days. Meow would flip over backwards all the time. It was really sad.
I feel like that's not good, though.
No, it wasn't good. It was scary every time.
I feel like it's got to be Yodel Kid, though. Like,
I
know.
He just stands at Walmart and yodels. That's all.
Yeah,
that's what he does.
He was famous.
They played
for
a remix.
A while.
He was at Coachella.
What?
He has like records, like albums.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's just him yodeling, or what?
Yes. This dude on Instagram drummed for him.
What?
Yeah.
That's kind of amazing.
And he got to start just from like. Doing
that,
it at Walmart.
From that video.
He played Washington Square Park.
Oh my gosh. Alright.
All right,
well,
I'm
now you guys got
two,
you got me convinced. I'm saying one.
I like the hamster, so
I'm like
saying
trick,
two.
I didn't know all these things, but you guys convinced me.
I just
want to
say the hamster.
Alright.
I hope it's the
hamster. Dang it!
Oh
it's
my
no!
Hamster.
No! Woo! I was like, this is going to be a trick one.
I hate this game.
Katie is dominating right now.
I want to kick something.
4-2-2-1. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Alright.
Okay.
Let's go. Let's see your next one, Benny. See what we got here.
I'll freak out.
Oh no.
Oh no.
She's gonna.
What?
Oh my gosh.
What is that?
He's like trying to eat.
I think it's a hamster or a rat.
Oh my gosh.
That was weird. Slightly
I hope
disturbing.
It's number one.
my people falling down theory failed me last time, but I'm sticking with it. Yeah.
Number two,
I'm gonna go number one.
Odd. Number two is just really weird. I'm
it looks like,
but it could be something like you'd share with your friends though. Like, look at this weird hamster. I don't know.
He's like in the glass.
He's like trying to escape, but it's like solid.
Yeah, I have
like
no idea.
It looked like another hamster was coming out of his mouth at first. I was like, did he eat it, baby? What is happening?
That would have made it a lot more views if another
hamster
crawled out.
All right, I'm
going to
say that little
aliens.
Girl.
People,
kids. No, you can't all say one. I have to get a point.
Too late.
Kids falling down is really funny.
I got nothing to lose.
It
doesn't count. I changed it. I changed it as it was coming up.
Cheater.
These are low view counts.
Dang it.
Probably still enough to monetize, right? You can monetize it like 10,000 views, right, or something?
Yeah, you can monetize it like 1,000 views.
We have like 20 views on last week's Velocity, so that's pretty good.
And I'm four of them.
I might be like five of them. All right. What did I say? I said one. We all said one. We all got it wrong.
Yeah,
so 2-2-4-1. Okay.
Shut up, guys.
One more? This is the last one.
No,
oh
it's
gosh.
Not.
No. What? Is it? Did we already make it?
Is it, Benny?
I think there's only eight in this round. There's only eight in this one.
Aww. Is this the last one?
That's
yikes.
Sad.
Well, this last one we forgot to mention is worth 3 points. So.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Everyone, I pick. You guys
lose.
All have to pick the opposite.
Yes. Just
no way,
just
dude.
So Katie can still lose. All right.
Wow.
3 points on the line. Let's see it.
Oh, my. Oh, that's so cute. It's a baby otter.
That's not funny, though.
But a lot
adorable.
Of people would watch it, though.
I know.
Cute animal videos go far.
Oh, they're both cute animal videos. Shoot.
What's he doing? Just sleeping.
It'd be really funny. I woke up and I was like, start snarling.
Yeah, these videos weren't as good as the last one.
Okay.
I should have previewed it.
My gut says one because it's an otter, so.
Dang it.
That's cute.
Okay, well, I'm going to say two then, because it's the only chance I have of beating Katie.
Okay.
All right, I'm
I'll
saying
just
two.
I'll accept it. If Mark wins, Jared
I'm
can't beat
two.
Me, so.
Yeah, but I cannot lose.
He can beat
me. Oh, wait, wait till it beeps, Ben.
We
don't show
tie,
the answer.
But
wait till it
oh,
beeps.
Wait, sorry, I already.
Wait, well, Allie, what are you picking?
All right,
okay.
I'm saying
one.
Two. All
right,
I'm
let's
saying
see what it
two.
Is.
Please,
come on,
please.
Come on, come on.
Let's go. Wait, how many points do you have?
Two.
I should have. Pick two! One! The one that was right!
Yeah.
Wow.
Sorry, Jared. Jared
that was
no, that was last
you,
week's
buddy.
Game. That was really quick. This one, this
okay.
wasn't as good as the last
no.
YouTube
no.
showdown. Well, I don't know.
Sorry.
I don't. There's not one out there. We could make one.
Mark, we should arm wrestle, and then they can vote on who wins.
Okay.
How do you
maybe
vote
next
on?
Week. I don't know.
next
week is our last Velocity, so we'll think of some fun stuff to do. And. Yeah.
Mark's got
cool.
sad strength. He'll beat me.
I don't know. I suck at arm wrestling. All right, we'll give it up for right. Katie and Allie, our
Bye.
Game girls. Thank you, girls, so much for everything you do. A couple of quick things we want to let you guys know about as our band is getting ready up here. First things first is next week is our last week of Velocity, and unfortunately, we're still not allowed to gather in groups bigger than 10, I believe, in Michigan. Yes, boo indeed. So we will be online next week for the last Velocity of the year, but we want you guys to come and hang out with us. We got some cool prizes we're going to be giving away, some special stuff. We hope you guys are here for that. And then we also wanted to let you all know that mark your calendars for June 24th, which is a Wednesday. We are going to throw a graduation party for Velocity here at the church. We're just going to celebrate all of our graduates because we're not able to do our senior banquet. We're not able to do some of the stuff we normally do to celebrate you. And we're hoping that by June 24th, we'll be able to gather in bigger groups. So we're going to come together. We're going to have some pizza. It's going to be outside. We're going to have me and Jared are going to set up some staging. Our full band's going to do some music. We're going to do some DJing, some dance parties, some pizza. And it's going to be sick. So June 24th, mark your calendars. Make sure you come hang out with us on that night. All right? Oh, last thing, seniors who are out there, if you haven't sent us pictures and a video yet for the senior video, we need those by Monday, June 1st. So get those in to me, like, soon. You can go to crossroadson23.com/cares, and you'll find the link to send that stuff to us, and I'll make sure you get it to us by Monday so we can celebrate you Senior Sunday, June 7th. All right? I think that's all I got for us. We're going to do some worship now. And we got three jumpy songs, right, Jared? Three jumpy songs.
Yes.
All right, guys, we're going to sing a couple songs. This first one's called Alive. We hope you jump with us. We hope you have some fun with us wherever the heck you are, man. Let's go.
Get your dancing shoes on.
All right, friends.
Set me free. Everything. of this world will fade. Pressing on till I see your face. I will live that your will be done. And I won't stop till your kingdom comes.
Baby, how you guys feeling? You feeling okay?
I'm feeling okay.
Feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Yeah, me too. I got sunburned real bad the past 2 days, so my guitar strap is like, it just hurts big bad.
I'm sorry, bro.
It's okay. I'm feeling good. Worshiping the Lord with you guys in the best way possible by jumping around and making a fool of yourself. I hope that you guys are doing the same wherever you are, and you're not just watching us, because the best way to be. It's just be a fool.
That's right.
You know? Woo! You ready to not stop singing? Because we can't stop singing.
Yeah, we better not.
That was the smoothest transition I could come up with. Hands up.
Forever, you won't let me go.
shimoles. Holy shimoles. Guys, I'm feeling good. Feels good just to be here worshiping Jesus with you all. I say you all as I'm looking at this tiny camera we named Mevo. And he doesn't give me a whole lot of feedback, so it's a little awkward when I have conversations with him.
That was funny how you said he doesn't give me a lot of feedback, because there's a double entendre there. It's kind of funny. Anyway, we're going to learn a new song tonight. It's called Echo. Shut up. It's a dancing one, man. So, you know, feel free to stand up wherever you are. And let's just shake your booties a little bit for Jesus.
Shake, Señor.
All right, here we go.
When night is falling, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind tends, I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me.
Jesus, that's just a prayer to you tonight that no matter what we go through, no matter what we got going on in our lives, through this quarantine, through this virus that we have, that we just know that you're not giving up on us. As though times are hard right now and it's hard to stay in touch with you as youth group and churches and things, it's not the same as it used to be, so it's hard to stay in touch, but I just pray that you're with us through all this, that we can just turn to you and turn to each other and turn to our small group leaders and through to
Mark and just everyone, that we can just focus our eyes on you in these hopefully last weeks of whatever this new normal is, and that we can get back to our normal soon. In your name we pray. Amen.
All right, guys, we're in week two of The Chase, and we invite you to check out this video here. Yeah, hey, welcome, guys. We're so glad you're here once again. Man, Velocity, we're here, you're here, I'm here, Katie's here. It's a good day, bro. It's a good day. All right, so I want to ask you guys a question tonight. I want to start off by asking you guys a question. How many of you remember taking your first steps? Y'all remember that? It's a good day, bro. I wonder if you remember taking your first steps, because that's like a huge milestone in all of our lives, right? Like the moment we go from just crawling around to that first moment we just stand up and we start wobbling around a little bit like a penguin. It's a big milestone in your life. And the reality is probably a lot of you guys don't remember it. And if you do say you remember it, you're probably a liar. But man, I've been calling out liars a lot these past couple weeks. Maybe it's on my heart. I don't know. But anyway, I guarantee you, even if you don't remember it, I guarantee you someone in your life remembers you taking your first steps, whether it was one of your parents, your mom, or your dad, whether it was your babysitter maybe, or your grandparents, or your step-parents, whoever was there with you. And chances are, when you did that, they wanted to tell everybody because it was such a big milestone. Maybe they posted something on Facebook or a video on Instagram, or maybe they just texted everybody or called everybody because they wanted everyone to share in celebrating your first steps. And the reason is because it's a huge milestone. And when we're babies, when we're little, man, everything is a really big deal. Everything is a big milestone. Your first solid food, your first steps, the first time you don't need a diaper anymore. Like, all of those are huge milestones that people just tend to celebrate almost everything. When we're babies, when we're younger, first steps are a really big deal. It's a really big deal because it's changed the trajectory of our entire lives. But the thing I've noticed is that as we get older, we tend not to be as good at celebrating small steps, right? Like, again, when we're babies, people be celebrating everything, going crazy and celebrating with us. But when we get older, we're not, like, celebrated as much. You know what I mean? Like, there's still some big stuff that gets celebrated. Like, maybe when you make a travel team, bro, and you made that travel team and your parents go nuts and they celebrate and post about it and things. Or maybe it's when you get a part in a play that you were really hoping for. Or maybe it's when you ace a class that you thought you were going to do terrible in. There's some celebration there. Or obviously, you seniors graduating, man, we want to celebrate that, and we're going to do everything we can to celebrate that with you. But as you get older, the big things seem to be the only things that are really celebrated. And maybe that's just fine. Maybe there's not a big problem with that, right? I mean, it'd be pretty weird if you were putting on your shoes in the morning and your mom broke out her camera and was like, look at my baby tying his shoes, you know? It'd be pretty weird if, you know, you, brushed your teeth and your dad broke out his camera and was like, there's my boy, look at him brushing his own teeth. That kind of freak you out a little bit, right? Or maybe if your grandparents dropped you off on your first day of school, like maybe they did in kindergarten like they did for me, and they like were waving and like, oh, have a great day, you're going to do great. You know, it'd be kind of weird. It'd be kind of embarrassing, right? So maybe it's a good thing we don't celebrate stuff as much as we used to. But you know what we're going to do tonight? We're going to practice celebrating. And I want you guys to do this, man, wherever you're at. I want you guys just to go nuts in a minute here, okay? Like, scream and shout. And I need proof of this, okay? So if you do this, take a video and send it to me, okay? And we'll share it in our story and everything else. But we want to practice celebrating. I want you to pretend like the Lions just won the Super Bowl, bro. Like, think about how bananas We're going to go in Metro Detroit when the Lions, notice I said when, not if, win the Super Bowl. So we're going to practice this, okay? I want you to cheer as loud as you can. Are you ready? I don't know, again, because you're in the camera, but I'm trusting you guys. You know, be real with me. Are we ready? All right, one, two, three. Yeah! Oh, man, doesn't that just feel good? It feels so good to celebrate, bro. And actually, what I want to do, I want you to practice a little more, but I'm going to give you guys some help. I asked some of the people on our staff to send me videos just celebrating some small accomplishments that I want to share with you guys right now, okay? So some of my friends are going to chime in when I share some good stuff I did. Okay, so first thing that I did today that was a pretty big deal is I woke up out of bed and I didn't pee in the bed.
Go, Mark. Go, Mark. Go, Mark. Go, Mark. Go, Mark. Go, Mark.
Yeah, yeah. So that was pretty good. I also didn't forget to put my car in park when I got to work today. Also, I saved enough money to put a down payment and buy a house here in Sylvania.
It's just incredibly hard to put into words how proud I am of Mark Ortis. Just keep it up, my friend. Keep it up.
I also ate some french fries yesterday without spilling any ketchup on myself.
Woo! Let's go, Mark. Let's go. Woo!
It's pretty good, right? I also, Lisa and I just recently paid off one of her student loans.
Oh my gosh. Come on. A little bit more. Come on. You got this. Come on. Woo!
And I tied my own shoes this morning. Good, right? Yeah, thank you. Actually, yeah, I did. I tie these ones. Some of my shoes I don't. These are my Vans. I do tie these ones. But did you notice some things about, yeah, these are my Velocity shoes. I don't know if you guys can see them. They're orange and blue. But I don't know if you guys have noticed that there's some things in there that were pretty cool to celebrate, right? But there are some things that you wouldn't really celebrate. Maybe you'd celebrate if like a baby or a toddler or a child did them, but not necessarily a 35-year-old man, unless some of y'all know me and you know tying shoes is a big accomplishment for me. But we don't celebrate that stuff as much anymore. And the problem is that there are some areas of our lives where even the small steps should still be celebrated, but as we get older, they're just not. And one of the biggest areas I can think of is in our faith walk. I mean, think about it. When you guys first gave your life to Jesus, if you've dedicated your life to Jesus, whether it was at a conference or at Velocity or at Spring Hill, I know a lot of kids in our youth group give their heart to Jesus at Spring Hill. Excuse me, I just burped. That's awkward. But y'all remember when we're at Spring Hill and people give their lives to Jesus, the place goes nuts, right? Like everyone loses their minds, they're screaming, they're jumping around, everybody's hugging, everybody's crying, it's very emotional. It's like a big old party, right? Because you gave your life to Jesus. You were dead and now you've been made alive through the blood of Jesus Christ. It's a really big deal. Or maybe your baptism. Y'all may have been to a baptism service here at Crossroads before. And you know that when people get baptized, when they go under and come back up, we just go bananas here at Crossroads. People jump out of their chairs. We cheer. We get the big bam, the band does, you know, and all that fun stuff. We're really good at celebrating that kind of stuff. But there's other steps we take in our faith walk that don't tend to be celebrated as much, you know? Like, I mean, when I read my Bible today, when I did my reading for the YouVersion study we're doing called The Chase as a youth group, which you can find the link for that on our Instagram page. But when I did that, I didn't necessarily have a ton of people waiting to high five and go nuts and jump up and down, you know? When I talk to God every day, when I pray with him, I don't have a lot of people throwing a big old party for me and jumping up and down and doing all that kind of stuff, you know? So maybe you'd felt that way before. Maybe you know how that feels. So that brings up a pretty good question in my mind. What do you think God celebrates? What do you think God notices about our faith walk that makes him celebrate, that makes him party? You know, maybe your mind goes to something like someone going on a mission trip to a foreign country. Like, surely God would celebrate that, right? Or maybe selling a bunch of stuff and giving the money to the poor. That's what Jesus asked the rich young ruler to do. Of course, God would celebrate that, right? Or maybe it's helping others begin their journey of faith by sharing your journey of faith with them. Obviously, God would be super pumped about that. And the reality is, yeah, God would most definitely celebrate those things. Those are all
really good things. But for most of us, those things seem like a really big deal. And for some of us, it may seem like some of those things are unreachable, like we'll never get to that level of God celebrating us because we just can't do those really big things. And sometimes we look at our own steps of faith, and they just seem pretty small. They seem pretty small compared to what we consider to be a really big step of faith. I mean, sure, God cares a lot about someone moving to Africa and providing a well of fresh water for a community, right? But does God really care if I put down my phone for 2 minutes and just pray and talk to him and spend some time just between me and him? Is that really something God would celebrate? Like, do those small steps, do those even count? Well, that's exactly what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about those small steps. And to do that, we're going to turn to the Gospel of Luke again. And y'all remember that the Gospel of Luke is more than just a book. It's a firsthand account written by a guy named Luke who was a doctor. So he took really close details of everything that was happening in Jesus' life. He was so fascinated by the life of Jesus Christ that he started taking notes of all these things, and now it's included in our Bible. So at this part in the story, he tells the story about when Jesus meets a man named Matthew. He's also known as Levi. And he kind of records what goes down between Jesus and Matthew. So it picks up here in Luke chapter 5, verses 27 through 28. This is where we'll be hanging out today if you guys want to follow along with us. But here's what it says. It says, after this, Jesus went out and saw a tax collector by the name of Levi sitting at his tax booth. Now remember that. Remember that Levi was a tax collector. And we'll get to why that was such a big deal in just a minute here. Follow me, Jesus said to him. And Levi got up, left everything, and followed him. Now, at first glance, this doesn't look like that remarkable of a story, right? I mean, Jesus went up to somebody, said, follow me, and he followed him. And it seems like at first glance, I thought, oh yeah, that's dope. That's a really cool story, you know? But there's a lot more going on in these two short verses than you probably realize. First, it says Jesus saw Levi, meaning he noticed him, not just like he glanced past and looked at him, but he really saw Levi. He saw him as one of God's children. He saw him who was a tax collector, and he talked to him. Now, see, back then, that doesn't seem like a big deal, right? But back then, tax collectors were like the most hated people on the face of the planet. I mean, we've talked about this before at Velocity, but tax collectors, what they would do is they were charged with collecting taxes, right, for the government. But what they also were allowed to do was charge anything they wanted to over what was due to the government. So, for example, it'd be like I walked up to Baker's house, right, to collect taxes from Baker, and I'd be like, all right, Baker, government wants $10 from you, and then he's digging in his wallet, and I'm like, no, wait, you know what? The government actually wants $30 from you, and he couldn't refuse. It was legal for me to do that and then give the $10 to Caesar and pocket the other $20. So it was almost like legal stealing. And you say, well, why didn't people just not do it? Why didn't they stand up for themselves? Well, the reality is they couldn't. Because if you didn't pay the tax collector what he asked for, he'd find it in some other way. Maybe it would be taking your daughter. Or maybe it would be taking your son as a Roman soldier and raising him up to serve the Roman soldiers. You know, whatever it was, they found a way to collect what they wanted to collect. So tax collectors were just known as like the worst of the worst. Like, people didn't talk to them unless they were, like, yelling at them some four-letter words that would make your mom slap you at the dinner table, you know? That was the only thing said to tax collectors. Like, everybody hated them. So the fact that Jesus, who was starting to gain some traction, by the way, this was after he'd performed some miracles, he was getting people following him, people were believing that he was who he claimed to be, the Son of God. And all of a sudden, the Son of God, the sinless man, right? All of a sudden, he's talking to a tax collector. The same tax collector who's been robbing these families for years. The same tax collector who ordered to have their kids dragged away from them or had you dragged into the street to be beaten because you wouldn't pay what he told you to pay. Now, all of a sudden, Jesus is just chilling with this guy. Just hanging out with him. And beyond that, he was asking him to follow him, become one of his disciples. There was a lot of ramifications to what Jesus did simply by talking to him, because at that time, simply talking to a man of that reputation like Levi's would ostracize you from the whole community.
that everyone else would stop talking to you because you associate with this vile, vile human being. And yet he was the one that Jesus approaches and says, come follow me. You know, if you're like me and you grew up in the church, you might have grown up thinking of the disciples of Jesus as like dudes with like halos around their heads. I mean, that's how you see them portrayed, right? When you go to museums or in churches with stained glass windows, you see the disciples with these halos, right? And these heavenly beings. But the reality is, man, they weren't even good citizens. They weren't the head of their class. They weren't overachievers. They weren't even good religious people. The reality is a lot of the disciples that Jesus chose were outcasts. People that had been thrown aside by society. And yet Jesus chose those 12 guys to be the first small group, right? To be the people that he was going to take with him on a journey to change the world. You know, Jesus saw Levi. He saw something in him that nobody else in this world was able to see. And probably Levi didn't even see in himself. It was almost like by extending this invitation to come with him and follow him, Jesus was saying, you know, Levi, I know you're a guy that I want to be associated with. I'm not worried about what people think or the bad things you've done or what people think about you. I just want to hang out with you. So why don't you step up and take a step and come follow me? And you know what's even more remarkable about this story is what Jesus didn't say, right? Jesus didn't go up to him and say, go and give away all your money back to the people you stole it from, then you can come follow me. Jesus didn't say, well, first you got to pay some penance for the bad things you've done, and then you can come follow me. Jesus didn't even say, first you have to, you know, read this passage, you need to pray, you need to do all of these things to get your life right, and then follow me. No, Jesus said to him, he simply asked Levi to follow him right then, right there, just as he was. And you know what Levi's response was? We read it, right? Verse 28, Levi got up, left everything, and followed him. Levi got up, left his tax collecting table, left all the taxes he had collected, all the money behind, and he just started following Jesus. He didn't know where Jesus was leading him, right? He didn't do all of his homework. He had no idea the adventure Jesus was about to lead him on. That's what's almost more crazy about his story than Abraham's, because Abraham followed God's leading. He took that first step, like we talked about, into the wild, right? But he was promised that he was going to be the father of many nations. He had that promise and that reason to trust God and to follow God. But Levi, man, I don't know what it was that made him say, you know what? Yeah, all this, I'm going to leave this and come with you. I don't know if it was simply the fact that, you know, that kind of love had never been shown to him before. Maybe he had never seen that kind of compassion before, that a man would take the time to look at a tax collector and not only see him, but go and talk to him and ask him to come on this journey he was going on to transform the entire world. But it started with one step, and that's our main point. I want you guys to remember tonight that chasing Jesus, it starts with a step. Chasing Jesus doesn't mean all of a sudden your entire outlook on life is transformed, even though encountering Jesus can have that effect on people. It doesn't mean, you know, you have to do all these things to please Jesus, right? Because last week we talked about how chasing Jesus means not chasing performance. Chasing Jesus starts with one step. You know, even though Levi took a small step, right, that's first step away from his table, it doesn't mean that it was an easy one, right? I mean, keep in mind that Levi had no idea what he was in store for. He was venturing into the wild. He didn't know what was ahead of him, where he would go. He didn't know what would happen or what he might have to give up if he stepped up and followed Jesus. He didn't know that we'd still be talking about his decision to follow 2,000 years later. But he didn't have to know all that to take that first step. He took a baby step of faith. Because he trusted God enough. He trusted Jesus enough to follow him. And that small step mattered to Jesus. Because right after he took that small step, there was a party at Levi's house. Jesus was invited, and he was right there in the middle of it with all the other tax collectors and what the Bible calls sinners. And Jesus started hanging out with all of them and loving them and seeing them in a way that only he could. Levi got to be a part of something he never imagined. Why? Because every small step towards Jesus counts. You know, the reality is, I don't know where your relationship with God is right now. Some of you may feel like you had a relationship with Jesus, but he just feels really far away. Some of you may feel like you have a relationship with Jesus and he feels really close. And some of you might be in a place where you're just like, dude, I have no idea what I feel right now, where Jesus is, where God is. I have no idea where I'm at. But here's what I know, okay? Here's what Pastor Mark knows. Just by taking a step, no matter where you're at with Jesus, just by taking one step towards him, you'll be closer to him than you were before taking that step. And the other thing I know is that the closer you get to Jesus, the closer you get to being the person that God created you to be, the closer you'll be to being that person that looks at people like tax collectors and sinners and sees something in them, sees something worthy of loving that other people might not see. So what could that small step look like in your life? Well, maybe for you, the small step could be reading one verse of scripture every day. Maybe you don't read the Bible at all, or you never open the Bible. Maybe you can start now. You know, this reading plan we're doing called The Chase on YouVersion, which we'll post a link to again tonight. It has one verse every day. They take about 1 minute to do. And maybe you say, you know what, my next step is just spending 1 minute with Jesus every single day. You may look at me and say, Mark, that doesn't seem like anything. That's like nothing. But you know what? It's a small step closer to Jesus. Maybe for you, the small step could be being kind to someone who isn't kind to you. Maybe starting at home. It could be a small step of inviting someone into a struggle you're having by talking to a small group leader about it and not trying to carry that struggle alone. It could be a small step of being nicer to your mom. It could be of showing up to church one more week out of the month than you do now. It could be a small step of volunteering, helping someone in need, getting involved in a local nonprofit. It could be a small step of developing a habit of gratitude where every single day you say, you know what? I'm just going to start off my day by giving thanks to God for who he is. You might ask me, well, how do you know? How do you know one small step would have that big of an impact later down the road? My answer to you is because I have a few friends who one small step completely altered the course of their life, and I want to share their stories with you right now.
Hi, Velocity. I just wanted to share with you guys one milestone in my faith is when I chose to get baptized the summer before my freshman year in high school. And one small step that led to that would just be really surrounding myself with positive people and people who supported me in my faith and my journey with Christ.
Hey Velocity, it's Amy. Shout out to my freshmen. I miss you. Our weird conversations and playing hide and go seek with you. My week is empty without them. I would say that one of my milestones in my faith would be getting my purity ring. I got it in 7th grade, so I was like 11, 12. I'm 21 now. I've had this thing for like 10 years. The reason I got it was because I had recommitted my life to Christ at Spring Hill in 7th grade. And for me, it just kind of symbolizes taking ownership over my faith walk and my relationship with Christ and not having to worry about how other people saw me, but only having to focus myself on Christ.
Hey, hey there, Velocity, 7th graders. I miss you a ton. A big milestone in my journey was getting baptized, which didn't happen until I was well into adulthood. But a small step that led to that was the very first time I went to youth group on a Wednesday night with one of my friends. And that started my journey into Christianity. And after that first night, I was at church every Wednesday, started going every Sunday. And eventually that led up to my baptism as an adult. Can't wait to see you guys. Hope it's soon. Bye.
Okay, Mark wants a short blurb about a milestone or a small step in my faith journey. Yes, I know I need a haircut. It's been a really long time. Quarantine does this. The first big step I can remember is being in college many years ago and seeing a lecture, which was given by an entomologist, guy who studies bugs and things, so very sciencey. And the lecture, I sat through it and it basically opened my eyes when someone asked how he could be a scientist and still believe in God. And he said, like, why do those two have to be mutually exclusive? There's nothing in the rule book that says that, no matter what your professors tell you. And that, just going there was a step for me, leading me to Bible study and meeting some other great guys at the university. But everything just starts with going out on a limb sometimes. Okay, that's my story. Hi.
Hey guys. So a big step in my faith was my first missions trip. It kind of changed the whole course of my life, really, and it's put me in the direction I'm going now. And to get there, I really just started going to Velocity on a more consistent basis, trying to get more involved. Basic stuff that most of you guys are already doing, so don't feel pressured, you got this.
Hey guys, it's Kevin and Chelsea here. We hope y'all are doing well. So Mark asked us to talk about a milestone in our life that's led us to Christ. And I have to say for me, that was probably when I recommitted my life to Christ, when I went back to Crossroads. I started going to Crossroads when I was about 10 years old. And once I got into high school, I kind of fell away from the church for a little bit, and I kind of got into some bad habits. And then as I got a little bit older, I took a step and I went to another church called Soma, and I had just gotten over a bad breakup, and I just felt like God was calling to me. So I went to this other church, and I just really connected to some of their worship music, and I really felt like, yes, I need to have God back in my life. So by going there, that led me to going back to Crossroads, which led me to recommitting my life to Christ.
Yeah, I think for me, it was, I never went to church growing up. It wasn't just a part of my life. My family never went, and so I really didn't start going to church until I met this one here. And so we went to church for a little while. We were dating for a couple of years, and the time came where we could get baptized up at Somerset Camp up in the pond or the lake that they have there, which was really cool. So my biggest moment, I think, was getting baptized. And I actually got baptized by her dad, which was cool, and my father-in-law now, and then my sister as well. So that's my stuff. We just want to give a shout out to our sophomores. We miss you guys.
We miss you guys so much.
We do. We can't wait to see you guys. We hope you're all doing well.
We'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Peace out.
You know, guys, the point of all of this is, and the point of those videos is, small steps are a big deal. May not look like it now, but when you're able to take small steps towards Jesus, you get closer to him than you were before. And will it be easy taking these small steps? Not necessarily. I mean, look at Levi. A step towards Jesus meant stepping away from something that he was already doing. And that might be the case for you too. You know, it may mean in order to take a step towards Jesus, you take a step away from a habit that you know is toxic to your spiritual and physical and mental health. It may mean taking a step away from a relationship that you know is toxic for you and not good for you. It may be taking a step away from someone who's a bad influence. It may be taking a step away from your comfort zone. It can be any number of things that it may mean stepping away from, and it can definitely be scary. But listen, steps towards Jesus don't always have to be dramatic and extreme, but even small steps are a really big deal to Jesus. Why? Because even small steps towards him are steps towards him. And the closer you get towards Jesus, the farther you get away from the darkness that's trying to keep you from him. The closer you get to discovering what your purpose for being created in this world is. You guys know this at Velocity. We say all the time that you were made on purpose and for a purpose. And the closer you get to Jesus, the closer you get to figuring out what that purpose is. You know, none of us remember our baby steps, but they were really important, right? It was a first step in a whole new world for us. And my guarantee to you tonight is that when you take these small steps in your faith, you're going to remember them, just like our small group leaders did. And you're going to look back at that point in your life and say, that first small step that seemed like not a big deal is what led me to the person that I am today. Even small steps towards Jesus are still towards Jesus. Chasing Jesus starts with a step. You don't have to do something huge, but do something, okay? take that small step and just watch what God does. Levi didn't know what a small step towards Jesus would do, and neither do you, but I promise you this, God does. And if we trust him enough to take that first small step, it'll give us courage to take more small steps, and we'll just start getting closer and closer to him and closer to being the people that he created us to be. Let me pray for you guys. So God, tonight, my hope is that everyone who's hearing this message tonight might think about what small steps they could take towards you. You know, so often we look at the small steps we take in our lives and they seem so inconsequential. Like, who really cares if I read my Bible for a minute a day? Who really cares if I start praying every day? Who really cares if I give thanks to you every day? It seems like such small things. But the reality is, even small steps are steps towards you. So whether everybody watching tonight, whether they feel close to you or so far away from you, my hope is and my challenge to all of them, God, is that they would take one small step. They would commit to taking one small step just to see the way that you could use those small steps to grow something inside of them. God, maybe for some people tonight, that first step is just finally turning over their life to you. Maybe they've been challenged with giving their hearts to you time and time and time again, but maybe tonight it's the time for them to take that first step towards you. And I pray, God, that if they are thinking of doing that, that they would have the boldness and courage to take that first step, just like Levi did tonight. That first step Levi took led towards some amazing things that we're still talking about 2,000 years later. God, help us to have that same boldness, that same faith, that same trust to just take the next step, whatever that might look like for us. We love you, God, and we pray these things in your name. Amen. All right, guys, well, you know, we got to send you out of here singing, right? Now, I want you to hear this song called Good Grace tonight that we're going to sing in just a minute here, because it's all about God's grace for us, and that's the reason even small steps are a really big deal to God, because even small steps toward him are steps toward him. So let's get the band back up here, and we'll close out singing tonight, close out worshiping. All right, guys, let's sing this last song together. Let's end our night worshiping. Get this song stuck in your heads, man. It's a good one. Let's go. So don't let your heart be troubled. Hold your head up high. Don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. So take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where our help comes from. Rise on. Let's sing this band together here, yeah? Let's go. So swing wide, all you heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All is creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All creation, clean hands, pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. All right, guys, sing it out. Let's go. Swing wide, all you heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. All creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All his children, clean hands, pure hearts, good grace, good God. His name is Jesus. Man, we hope that song gets stuck in your heads and you guys remember that for the rest of this week until you come back next week for the last Velocity of this school year until we got a bunch of cool stuff planned for the summer. We hope you guys have a great week. We'll see you next time.